Hey guys, Sandeep here from LearnTech again. Today, I will show you a demonstration of BMC tables. You know, in BMC Remedy, we have multiple ways of representing data in different types of tables. I have just taken an example here. I have a student database, or you can say information regarding the students. I will show you how we will present it in different tables. So let's start with it. So let me first of all add one table here. Let me go here. You know, in Remedy there are basically three types of tables. We have table list view, we have table tree view, we have table cell based. So we will see all three. So first I will add that list view. Okay, so you will be, people who are working with Remedy, they will be familiar with this table because this is used across Remedy for various purposes to represent data, and it's a commonly used table in BMC Remedy. Now I will add the data for this. So now to add a data to the table, I will just double click this. It will open the properties of the table. So what I will do here, I will go to the tables properties section, columns. So here I have to first of all select the form name. Either I can select the current form on which I am basically putting this table, but also in case you want to represent data from some another table, that also you can select it from here. You have to click here and then it will bring in the list of the forms or the tables you have in Remedy system. You can then use it, but currently we are taking this current form. So here in the qualification, you have to mention the qualification. If in case you want to present data in a table in a based on certain qualifications, then you can use it. So currently I will not use any qualification. This is just a basic example. So it will put all the data from this particular form into this table. It will show it. So let me go and add these fields. So I'll add this age, class, then I will add name, phone number, roll number, and status. I think that's it. So now here also I can rearrange them. So for example, I need to put name at the top. I will go like this, and status in the end. Okay, so we are good to go. Then click on the okay. So you can see this is how it is. Now it is showing you a table format. Now similarly, we will add another table in the current view. Right click, then I will go here as tree view. So now this is something which is like it's a hierarchy based table. We do not use it quite often, but in some cases it is used to build in when you are building a massive or a custom application and there is a way where you need to present data in a hierarchical way, then you can use it. So I will double click again on this. The process is same. I will add my data here. So age, class, then I have name, phone number, roll number. Okay, then status also. So similarly, I have added the columns here in this table, and I will say okay. Now we can see the data is presented like this. Now there is one thing which we need to do again in this table. So here we need to go in this sort levels. Now here the data, how when if you have to present it in a hierarchy, so in that case, let me add all of them. Now here is a trick. The trick is that the way or the field on which you want to sort this. For example, I want to sort this on active and inactive, then I will bring the status field up. In case I want to put it on based on class name, age, name, phone number, roll number, I can sort it like this. Currently, I will see it on based on the status field. So, okay, I will say okay. Fine. So, this is the tree-based table. Now, I will add another table. Let me show that is quite simple, like the first one. It is called cell-based table. So, in case sometimes you want to represent data in a cell format, like this. So let me put it here. Okay, let me drag these core fields down. Okay, so let me double click again. Then similarly, the process is same. I have to add the fields. So I will add age, I will add class, name, phone number, then status. I think this is it. So here also, I will just make the name at the top. So you can see if I just increase the size, so the data here will be presented something like this. So here also I can just rearrange the fields, set them in a proper order or format. Just that I will just make a formatting here. Okay, so now we have created three different types of table in Remedy to represent the data. Let me save this. So currently we'll be using an admin user to test it. Now I go back to my form. Here, let me flush my cache. Okay, let me refresh it. Okay, now if I click on refresh button, you will see the data has come here for these tables. Okay, there is some data here. Okay, so now we can see here how the data is presented. Let me go to new search. Okay, now if I click on refresh, you'll see here the data is presented based on active and non-active format. So it is based on the hierarchy, and the table is presenting the data. Similarly, if I go here, this data is presented like this, in a tabular format, and shows you the status. We can also write workflows, active links based on the row selection. There are a number of workflows which we can trigger that we will take in the separate videos. And similarly, cell-based table represents data like this. Can say sometimes if you want to present data to in a form for an application like this, you can use this table, or generally we use this table. There is one more thing I want to show you, that is for this particular table we can also control the row selection, the coloring of the row. So how it can be done, I'll go back to the developer studio. Here we will open this. Then there is a section called color. So if you click on this result color section, then you, first of all, you have to select, it will ask you for selection field. So if you click here, so by default, there is one field based on which we can color this table, that is status field. So I have already selected this status field. Otherwise, it is not showing it here. Otherwise, it will show you that field here. Okay. So now I have defined the color that for active, it should show green. For inactive, it should show red. Then I will click OK. It is already saved. I have to just flush the cache. So let me sync cache and see if it works. And then I will refresh this. So let's see now the data. If it is, so you can see now the data coloring has changed based on the status. If it is active, it will show you green, and if it is inactive, it will show you red. So the same way also you can do to present data for different applications, for different requirements, you can use it in this way. Thank you.